Hi everyone, Crash Test Airsoft here with another Tokyo Marui Glock 17 gas blowback video. What we're going to do today is we're going to build a kind of project gun built with aftermarket parts from one manufacturer. That manufacturer is UAC, or Ultimate Airsoft Custom. I've been using some of their parts on my skirmish pistol for some time, and the quality is exceptional. The fit is perfect. So I thought, wouldn't it be fun to buy every single UAC Glock 17 part that's available, and make it into a kind of project. The only part that I haven't bought off them is the stupid bottom extension for the magazines, which is eternally pointless. But every single other part I've purchased. So what we've got here to start the project is a Garda EU spec tan grip, and it's been fitted with a Maglock grip tape system, which I bought from Canada. It's for real steel, but it's really nice. I used a hairdryer to heat up the grip and heat up the glue, so I've stuck it down really, really nicely. This is a standard Garda grip with the standard work that's been done to it. I've run sandpaper along the top on a straight edge to make that really, really smooth and flat, and then, as you can see, the void behind the trigger assembly captive nut there has got a load of epoxy in it, so this is good to go. I've used an X-Acto knife to go round all of the internal mouldings and make sure that there's no sort of excess plastic there. So yeah, we'll go through all the UAC bits. I won't show you the build today. I'll show you it in steps, so as I fit each part. If you want to watch me build the Glock from scratch, you can check out my other video there. I'll just fit each bit, and I'll talk a little bit about the individual components and how they're better or worse or indifferent to the Tokyo Marui versions. So yeah, let's crack on. Well, it's Christmas in my house. Check this out. So in here, basically, we have got every single bit that UAC make for the Tokyo Marui Glock 17. Look at that. Brilliant. So we've got, what we got here, we've got a hop-up unit. We've got the aluminium valve blocker, we've got fibre optic sights, we've got the hammer and sear, the match grade hammer and sear, we've got aluminium loading nozzle, we've got the stainless steel chassis pin set, so they're for pressing through the body of the gun and building the hammer assembly. Here we've got the version 2 of the blowback unit, because I wanted the one with the O-ring because it fits better in this one. The stock Tokyo Marui piston doesn't really fit in this; it's too small. So you need to upgrade or downgrade, as the case may be, to get it to fit in this. So if you're using the version 1. It doesn't come with this brass assembly. It's just got a standard one with a hole on the end to screw the factory nozzle, factory piston on. If you use the version 1 and use the stock piston, really you want to use the stock or the Garda upgraded nozzle, like so, because basically that is the correct diameter, whereas these two fit absolutely perfectly together. I have tested them. What else have we got? We've got the stainless steel trigger lever. This is a part that I've been using on the Glock. It shortens the throw on the trigger. It's a lot more precise, really, really good thing. This I'm really excited about. This is the CNC aluminium front trigger housing. Again, I've had it all out, and it's absolutely beautiful. Here we have the tactical magwell. I had a bit of issues getting hold of this. I bought it from one of our favourite Hong Kong suppliers, and they actually sent me a high kappa aluminium nozzle. So what they'd done is they'd got the part number. Their part number was 00014, which is the high kappa nozzle, whereas this one is 00104. So obviously whoever was picking it at the factory cocked it up. This is the hammer spring, again a part that I've been using, really really good, it's kind of perfect really. This is a part which is well liked by people who know more than me. It's the reinforced aluminium hammer housing, but the tolerance of manufacturing is much tighter than the Tokyo Marui one. And then last but not least, we have the 135% nozzle spring. Now this you need. The reason being, the weight of the nozzle and the snug fit of the piston means that this, when it jams in the bucking, it's got so much weight in it that the standard spring may not pull it back into place. Well, it won't, because I've tried it. So whereas this thing works perfectly. So yeah, we've got one of those as well. And then last but not least, we have a bag of all the bits that you're going to need from the original gun, and we're going to go through those.
Okay, in here what I've got is basically all the bits that you will need to keep from your existing Glock, or you can buy them separately if you're building, you know, a straight project. What I'll do is I'll get these out and then I'll kind of arrange them into bits that go together, so that we can kind of categorise them. So we'll do that for you real quick. Got loads of little bits here. To be honest, if you did want to do it sort of from scratch, as it were, buying these parts isn't that expensive. Obviously buying the rest of it is. Right, okay, so what we've got is, as I say, these are all the bits that you'll need on top of all the UOC parts that I've bought. So you're going to need a barrel. Obviously the existing TM barrel is fine, but this is an upgraded gun. So here we've got the PDI 6.01mm barrel, really really nice Japanese made barrel. And then we've got the Lalax or 9 ball Prometheus VSR 10 bucking, which goes in most of the gas blowback pistols as well. So that's kind of the barrel side of things. We'll move that out of the way. You'll need a recoil guide and spring. This is the Lalax short stroke version. The reason I like this one is because it's got a thrust race at the end here. When springs compress, the contact point at the end of the spring will actually rotate. And this thrust race basically provides zero friction for that rotation. So basically as the gun goes back, it's got even less kind of friction on it, but this one is super smooth. It slides back with no noise, no friction. Combine that with some nice lithium grease and it's absolutely perfect. You'll need one of those. These are the parts that you will need from the nozzle. So obviously I'm using the aluminium valve knocker and the aluminium nozzle. The valve knocker comes with its own little screw, so all you'll need is the castle valve or turret valve, because I reckon it looks like a little castle turret there, and you'll need the spring to go with it. Don't change this spring from standard unless you're starting to upgrade the outlet valves in the magazines or anything like that. So you'll need those two. You'll need the slide catch. Okay, this is a Lone Wolf Guns modified version. It's ever so slightly longer, which is quite nice. It enables you to get your thumb and forefinger grip it nicely, so that's fine. These are the three parts that you'll need from the hop-up unit. So you'll need the tiny little O-ring. What that does is just produce a bit of friction to stop that turning of its own accord. So don't grease that, just let it run as just straight rubber. You'll need the hop adjustment wheel as well, and you'll need the hop up nub. So this little metal thing there is the bit that squeezes into the bucking and creates the backspin on the BB. So you'll need those three parts. These parts you will also need. This is a bit annoying. These do not come with the UAC trigger housing. What you've got here is you've got the spring for the slide catch, okay? But you also need the pin that secures the spring to the blowback, to the trigger housing, okay? So you'll need that. This I actually bought from Richard at Eagle 6 because he sells them separately. This might actually be the Garda spring. So you'll need those two for the trigger housing. You'll need the hammer housing securing screw. And obviously you'll need the trigger housing securing screw, which you need those two. You'll need the mag release and catch. This is the Garda steel mag release. It's the only one I use, highly recommended. You can have a serial number plate if you want. The gun will run fine without one of these, but obviously you'll have a hole in the bottom of the chassis. This one's blank, and I'm actually going to have this engraved with like UAC and then three kind of arbitrary numbers on there. And what I might do also is have this engraved with UAC as well, so that the gun is kind of finished as a UAC product. If and when I get that done, I'll post an update to this video and show you. You'll need the slide catch and spring. So you'll need both of those two off the original gun. And these are the parts that you'll need for the hammer assembly. Now, during filming this, I've actually ordered the Action 8mm bearing version of this, because I've actually found this sticking. Regardless of what grease you put on, I've actually found this sticks. So even though I'm going to sort of show you this here, I'm actually building the gun with the Action one, and believe it or not, it actually came in the post today, but I missed it, so I've got to pick it up on Monday. But you'll need this or an upgrade to it. You will need the valve knocker reset arm and the spring that goes with it. I'd stick to TM with these parts. I've experimented with the Garda versions, and they're not filed correctly. They don't have a final fitment which makes them work. This is the Garda version, and it looks pretty much identical to the TM, but it has this Defroit coating. But I've found this sticking, it doesn't really work. So you'll need the valve knocker, again TM standard, and you'll need the sear spring which goes on there. So that you'll need those parts, and then obviously you've got the hammer and the sear in the UAC upgraded format. So there you go. So those are all the bits that you need to either keep from an existing Glock or order them in separately, which is what I did because most of them are upgrades anyway. Combine that with all the UAC and Garda parts that we've got, and you're good to go. Right, these arrived yesterday. Very excited about this. This is the slide and barrel that I'm going to be using for this gun. Now, again, bit of a snobby bone of contention for all this, and just a word to the beginners among you. I have never had an issue with a Garda slide. If you speak to people who've been doing this since kind of before 2009, they say that Garda underwent a bit of a change in their manufacturing process, and ever since then their slides have been very much better than their kind of early ones. This is brand spanking new. This came out, what are we now? We're now Saturday. This came out on Tuesday. I ordered it from Rainbow 8 and it's already arrived. This doesn't have the markings for the first Gulf War on it. I find that a bit sycophantic, especially as we shouldn't have been there. Basically this is the Cerakote version of the standard Glock Garda slide, and as I say, I'm really psyched about this. As you can see, the finish is really, really nice. It's got the engraved there, GR076. That's what I might put on the serial tag I've got. I might put UAC076 on there. Comes with a separate ejector, which is done in an anodized black aluminium, and that looks really smart. The slide itself is aluminium, I'll be honest, I've actually kind of fitted this on, and it's lovely. It fits perfectly. It fits perfectly with the UAC blowback, fits perfectly with the standard TM blowback. And as I say, this is the third Garda slide that I've had, and I have yet had a fitment issue. The UAC fibre optic sight fits perfectly in there. The standard TM one fits perfectly in there. The adjustable UAC one fits perfectly in there. Likewise, the front, as you can see, I've already mounted that up. I was very excited when I received this and put the front slide in. So obviously, you'll notice that on the video is already fitted. But to be honest, it's just really, really, really smart. There's nothing wrong with it. And as I say, some people do raise issues with the fitment of Garda slides, but I've no real issue. In fact, I had a Guns modified slide which didn't work with the standard fitment on the chassis. I then put the original black version of this on, works perfectly every time. Whether the blowback is ever so much laboured compared to a top of the range Guns modified slide, I don't know, but no issues with these whatsoever. So that's really smart. Excuse me. This is the barrel I'm using. Now, I may change this because this is steel. I don't like running steel barrels with aluminium slides, but it's better that than the other way around. Don't use a steel slide with an aluminium barrel. It'll chew through it instantly. But again, this really, really nice, beautifully made. You cannot complain. I'm following the advice of my online colleague Knuckles on here, whereby he says make sure you use the same brand barrel, outer barrel, as you do slide, and I would tend to agree. The reason being is because the machining around here is all done to complement each other. This stuff doesn't matter so much. That communicates with the hop unit and things like that. But all this machining here is made to match. So if we get this and slide her in, basically the fit is as it should be. The fit is kind of perfect and snug. Obviously, once this is all combined, it won't rattle around. But so I've combined brands there. And also, what I'm tempted to do in a future project is buy the 7-inch high kappa PDI barrel and then run the brand new Garda compact pistol silencer. What that'll do is it'll bring the barrel to about here, and then you'll have about 4 centimeters of silencer on the end, and that will give you an increase in FPS and accuracy, and I think it might look quite pimp. So that's again a future possibility. This is a counterclockwise thread, this one. So obviously you need to take this off before you slide the barrel in, because it won't come out now like that. But that should look quite smart. So as I say, each their own, but I have never had an issue with Garda slide. I've always been told horror stories, but they're obviously doing something different at the moment, because there's nout wrong with these. Nothing wrong with them at all. So that's the slide we're going to fit to this gun. As I say, UAC, some of you high kappa owners might be able to tell me whether UAC makes slides, but they certainly don't make one for the Glock 17 yet, and they don't make an outer barrel either, so obviously you can pick and choose. I was tempted to put a Guns modified salient on this gun, but I've kind of changed my mind because it's not a salient grip, so it's kind of, you know, I don't want it to be, you know, a copy. So I thought I'd go for a full kind of desert tan gun with the black kind of details, and that should look quite smart. Cool. Right, first things first, we'll put the magazine release and spring in. Ta-da! Right, the first UAC part we're going to look at is the magwell. This is aluminium. I'd say it's probably 7075. It's been anodized in black. The quality of the machining is second to none, as you can see. I mean, it's so good, it looks like moulded plastic. It's got a kind of lug here which goes up inside the grip, and then we've got the securing bolt to the housing, and then we've got the bolt which secures this kind of lug onto the magwell itself. So that simply goes onto there, screw goes up the middle, we'll stick a bit of Loctite on there, like so. So yeah, I'll stick it on and we'll have a look. Okay, so that's the Magwell installed. Slid on absolutely perfectly. The inside of the grip lines up with the tapered edge perfectly. Yeah, it's just nice, and I think it looks really, really smart. It's kind of halfway between kind of subtle and tactical, really. It's not quite in your face, and because it doesn't have a shiny aluminium shiny anodized effect, it's matte, it's textured, which again I like. It's in fitting with the rest of this gun. The only thing that I don't like, and you guys have probably spotted it as well, is this god awful bolt sticking out the back. I may come up with a solution for that, and if I do, I'll post it. What I'm probably going to do is machine a larger amount of plastic out of the back, and then I'm going to use a short cap head bolt and kind of countersink it into the grip, because that kind of looks a bit pony to me. But as they each their own, I just think it's a bit unsubtle. It's not very neat. Yeah, so there you go. There's the Magwell on the grip. Okay, the next part we're going to pop on is the stainless steel trigger lever onto our gun's modified trigger. Exactly the same, really, as the standard Tokyo Marui one, except this one you screw in with the world's smallest grub screw, as opposed to a pin which you press through the standard trigger. So yeah, basically we will literally get this out, stick the pin through the hole there, and secure it. Now this is stainless steel. It's really, really, really tough, much tougher than the standard TM one. But also this sear release here has been modified, and its dimensions have been changed so that if you're just running the standard trigger, it's going to reduce the trigger pull enormously. Makes it much crisper, much nicer to fire. You know, the standard TM trigger, you're pulling back for like 7 millimeters before it fires, whereas this thing shortens it a lot. Combine this with the adjustable trigger, and I can actually get it to where I want it. I know everyone's preference is different. I want, you know, probably about 0.8 to a mil of trigger travel before it deactivates the sear and fires. So yeah, we'll put that on and pop it in. Okay, that's the trigger lever installed on the trigger. As you can see, the grub screw in here basically stops it there. So essentially what it's doing is it's pre-pulling the trigger, which is how it works. Pretty straightforward. But as I say, nice bit of kit. I would definitely recommend this as an upgrade for the standard TM. It's so much crisper and nicer to pull. Right, this is the reinforced trigger housing by UAC. This is, along with the hammer housing, this is my favourite part that they do. The machining is sublime. Look at this. And then you've got, it's kind of made in two parts, look there, and you've got the two screws holding it together, and it is rigid, it is rock hard. I don't know if any of you have kind of played with like a bog standard, you know, Halford spanner. If you actually try and flex it across both ends, you can. It just feels like it's got some give. You then hold a snap-on one and try flexing it at both ends. Nothing. It's got no give whatsoever. It's rock hard. And this is the same. It's just completely rock hard. But the surfaces are smooth. The machining is precise. I already know it fits. And yeah, so we'll get this in. This isn't really a performance upgrade. Of all the UAC parts we're going to fit today, this one is kind of... it's kind of not essential at all, really, but it's super smooth, super flat. It's got no horrible kind of moulding marks or anything like that. It's just a nice, you know, CNC machine piece of kit. So let's go ahead and install it. Right, here we are with the main trigger chassis housing installed. Unsurprisingly, the fit is perfect. Now, obviously, this is a Garda grip. It's not a TM one, so... I don't know if the fit will be as good on the TM one, but this is perfect. It's snug without being tight. There's no play whatsoever. All the holes line up. Everything lines up. Really, really, really smart. So I'm going to go ahead and install the trigger bar and the main dowel that goes through, and then I'll show you again. Right, we're now going to open the pack of the dowels, which kind of hold all the various bits together. These are stainless steel as opposed to the mild steel kind of cast versions on the from the original gun. Again, machined stainless steel, beautiful. They fit absolutely precisely, especially with all the UAC parts that they go with. So we're going to take the biggest one there, and we're going to slide it through the main body of the gun. They are tapered, very, very subtly tapered, so you've got to kind of hold them up to the light to figure out, you know, which end goes in which. I generally, if I'm holding the gun, I like to put all my dowels in from right to left. They will grip on the right hand side, so the biggest side goes in last. So for example, on the body of this gun, I'll be going in from this side. The pin will taper outwards this way, and obviously as we bring it home this side, it will then start to grip and hold everything in place. So I'll go ahead and do that, and then we'll have a look. Right, so that's the main pin through the body, fits perfectly, and we have a really nice kind of smooth trigger action. Lovely. Right, we're going to build the hammer assembly now. This is one of my favourite things to do, and using these components, it's a real joy. Everything's machined so precisely that it just fits perfectly. Now, there is one issue which we must discuss, and that is the fact that they've used the standard design of the hammer, which means that this part of the hammer will contact the slide unless you file it off. So what I've done is put this in a vise, and I've filed it precisely the amount I want off. And as you can see, I've managed to get a nice clean finish on there. But make no mistake, these are made beautifully. And they're super, super hard machine steel. And they give a nice crisp trigger pull every single time. So what we'll do is we're going to use that. We're going to use the aluminium hammer housing. Obviously we've got the sear as well. And we're also going to use our UAC enhanced hammer spring. Enhanced hammer springs, obviously they're a question of debate. But if it's very, very warm, your magazine expands so much that the standard hammer spring doesn't have enough grunt to hit the valve hard enough to expel the gas. So a slightly stronger hammer spring is always useful. So we're going to need our sear spring. We're going to need our sear release. We're going to need the valve knocker release. We're going to need the valve knocker. We're going to need the valve knocker release spring. And we're going to need the slide roller. We will also need our stainless steel top hat dowel and our standard dowel. Again, these are the UAC stainless steel items. So I'll put it all together and then show you at the end. Right, here we are with the completed hammer assembly, using all the UAC parts, apart from the valve knocker, obviously. Really, really nice. I mean, it's crisp and smooth. There's no gripping or grabbing anywhere. Really, really nice. Yeah, lovely. And this hammer, like the trigger housing, this hammer housing fits absolutely perfectly inside the guard grip. So I will go ahead and install it, and we'll have a look when I'm done. Okay, that's the lower of the gun finished. So we've got the trigger assembly in. We've got our next stainless steel dowel through, and we've got our hammer securing screw in there. If we as you can see, barely any pull on there, which is the way I like it, and that fires smoothly every time. Lovely. Cool. So we'll get the rest of the UAC parts for the slide, and we'll put them all on, and Yeah, right, with the lower done, we're going to have a look at the parts that sort of all go in the slide. Obviously, those of you who know what you're doing with a Glock, you know what parts they are. But obviously, these are all UAC upgrade items. So we've got the rear sight, which is being used to hold the blowback housing in place. These are fairly highly regarded, even within the fibre optic sights that are available, purely because they use a 2mm fibre optic rod, and they're very, very clear. If we have a look at the, if we have a look at it, let's open it up. Okay, what we've got here is, can you see the slits in the top? They let the light into the fibre optic rod, but also we've got some really nice machined cuts here. Can you see the diagonal cut going through there? That's really nicely made. I think it's 7075 aluminium. It's quite hard. It doesn't feel like 6000 series to me. But yeah, really nice bit of kit. Perfectly symmetrical, obviously, and mainly fits beautifully in the garter slide. So if I undo the screw off the top, we can see that this drops straight in. There's no diagonal play at all. There's no fore and aft play. There is a tiny amount of side to side, so little you can't see it that much. But as I say, no fore and aft, no diagonal, just that tiny bit of side to side. And that will be taken up once it's gone into the back of the blowback housing. So that's really nice. That's a nice bit of kit. We've got the spring, don't need to say too much about that. What this is just a harder spring. So it's going to withdraw the nozzle from the bucking with a little bit more force. Just a wee bit, it's 135%. How on earth they measure that, I've no idea. We've got the blowback unit itself. We can have a quick look at that. So this is a yet another lightweight blowback unit. Pretty much everyone makes these now. You've got A1A, Ace One Arms. You've got, who else makes these? You've got Guns Modify make one, Garda make one, UAC make one, AIP make one. So everyone's coming out with them. This is the lightest, at 17 grams. So it's really, really light. Not really much to say on this, really. The machining, like all this UAC stuff, is absolutely perfect. It's so perfect. It looks like a computer rendering. I hold it sort of like that, it doesn't look real, but I assure you it is. And very, very stiff, even across bits that are machined kind of very, very thin. If I squeeze the two corners there, there's the tiniest amount of give. If we look at the crack between there, tiny bit of give there, nothing too bad. Obviously, torsionally, nothing. I can't twist that. It's completely solid, and it's super duper light. So if you're running a metal slide, you can go a bit easy on the recoil spring. Lovely bit of kit. Then got the nozzle loader. This thing is great. So the plastic, after a while, the TM plastic nozzles will crack, because the plastic just gets stressed time and time again, and it cracks. These things are obviously aluminium, but it's just not going to break. It's rigid in every direction. It's beautifully machined. One thing to note on this: the diameter of this is too big for the stock Marui piston head. In my experience, it's way too much gas passes by. So on this, you've either got to use the version 2 blowback unit with the integrated O-ring, because that fits kind of perfectly on there, and gives you no uh, gives you no pass. It's just gripping a tiny amount, which is what we want. But apart from that, not a lot to note, really. This really is bling. You don't need it. You can use a Garda enhanced one. But this is super duper nice. And it shouldn't break. We've then got the hock unit, which we'll come to later. And we've got this, which goes in our nozzle. This is an aluminium valve blocker. Now, again, those of you using CO2 or propane for a long period of time may find that this cracks. So UAC have done an aluminium one. It's identical to the TM one in every dimension, but it's just made out of aluminium. That's all. Still got the tiny little screw, which we're going to use a 00 Phillips head for. So just over time, again, the coal gas and the stress of it basically will crack the original plastic one around here and here. This thing will last forever with any luck. So, I mean, hopefully once we get all these blowback units and nozzles and valve blockers in, you should have a gun which will be good for CO2 for a long time. I'd be interested to know how quickly I could get the gun to fail running CO2 only. So we'll start with the build of the nozzle. We'll get the nozzle assembled. So we're going to put the valve blocker in. We're going to need to go into our cache of parts that we need from the original gun, because we're going to need the little turret head valve or castle valve or whatever you want to call it, that thing. And we need the spring that goes with it. There. So basically, we'll assemble all that together and I'll show you when it's done. Right, so here we are with the valve blocker installed in the nozzle. It's got a tiny little screw there. I've put a bit of Loctite 243 on there. And we can see there the little castle head there. Got free movement. This thing fits in obviously perfectly. It's machined completely to the same size. Not really much to say about it. Not much to say about all of this, really. It's if you want a masterclass in machining metal, UAC have it down to an absolute T. I mean, this thing is just insane. Look at all the cuts here. Now whether some of this is cast and then machined afterwards, I've no idea, but I can't see any seam lines. I can't see any joins in the metal. It's just wonderful stuff. I'm sure it's finished by hand. Things like this scallop out of here. So basically we've got our blowback unit here. This comes loose. This thing. I actually Loctited it last night, so it's gone off. So we can literally put a bit of silicone oil on there and pop the nozzle loader in. Right, so we have the nozzle installed in the blowback unit. Lovely movement there. I've put a bit of silicone oil on all the kind of parts that touch each other. So that's moving really nicely. So we can turn that over just there, and we can install the return spring, nozzle return spring. So we just pop that out of the packets, packet within a packet. Packaging is personal taste, really, for UAC. Some people like bags, some people do boxes. The only downside of this Garda slide is it's supplied in like a kind of bag thing, whereas a Guns Modified they give to you in a nice cardboard box. Doesn't really make much odds, but it depends what you like, really. So we'll put the return spring in there. I've installed the ejector, and we've got a nice flat surface on the inside of there to play with. So get our blowback unit with our spring in it. That slides in perfectly like that. All the surfaces are flush. I don't think you can see now the nozzle loader's in. But there's a round surface underneath here which matches up sort of perfectly. Now that we've got that in, obviously we can reverse it and we can install our rear sight. most of you, I'm sure, know that if you're running the TM gun, the sights are actually one of the only essential upgrades, because the plastic sight at the back will break, it will crack. So we're going to get another bit of Loctite on here, on this screw. As I say, this video isn't a build explanation, I've got a video for that. This is literally just showing you how well the all the UAC parts go together. So I'll just turn that area up. Right, so that's in. So we've got two sights on there. I installed the other sight yesterday evening. I do apologise. I wanted to get some Loctite on it so it would go off. Again, it's sometimes, you know, you get the dug out of the slide and the square pin doesn't go into it. This is a complete drop in, absolutely easy. So that's both in, and that's the rear nozzle in. So we can make sure we've got return spring action, which we do. Quite hard to grip. Oh, that's better. There we go. Nice. So we'll just drop a bit of oil in there. For those of you that haven't seen my build video, I'm actually using Radio Control Car shock oil. It's pure 100% silicon oil. This is a 27.5 weight, so it's ever so slightly thinner than the standard 35 for airsoft guns. Just means it gets into the nooks and crannies a bit better. So there we are. So that's the rear blowback and the rear sight installed into this lovely new FDE Cerakote guard slide. Right, so here we are with the UAC aluminium hop-up chamber. This is bling to an extent, but it's made to nicer tolerances than the TM one. The TM is, I think, cast and then machined. And it's kind of a bit crude and a bit horrible. This thing, like the rest of the UA stuff, is CNC to perfection, and the barrel fits absolutely perfectly in it. There is no play at all, which there shouldn't be, but it's a nice bit of kit. Sorry if I sound a bit down today. I've got a sore throat and I'm struggling a little bit. So this is the hop unit. So for the all you get with the UAC hop unit is you get the hop itself. You get the pin, which is going to log onto the kind of catch on the barrel, and then you get the screws as well. Now the pin here out of the box was ever so slightly too long, so I've actually filed that down. And I assume so that's they can give you whatever clearance you want for use with for different slides and things. So all you have to do, same as everything else, take apart the two halves, and I'll just show you how well these are made. Look at that machining. Look at the nodules on the inside there, which grip the barrel. Absolutely beautiful, and the two sides mate as if they were taken out of the same piece of aluminium. Really, really, really nice. Lovely. So I'll get this together. Obviously you need your barrel, you need your hop bucking, you need your nub, you need your adjustment wheel, and you need your wheel grip O-ring. And those are the bits that you need from your existing Glock to go with the UAC upgrade hop unit, so I'll put that together now. Right, so here we are with the UAC hop unit assembled. So the little wheel activates nicely on there, grips nicely as well. Obviously we've got our link pin there. The bucking is completely centered and pops into the groove really, really nicely. There's no seams or anything. The barrel is held completely securely. There is no play whatsoever. So we can take our outer barrel and just slide this in nice and gently, trying not to scratch it up too much. Yeah. That's in. Very nice. Okay, so we've got the hop unit and barrel installed in the outer barrel, so we can now basically assemble the slide itself. This is obviously not UAC specific. You know, essentially, actually, we're going Garda into Garda here, so very, very straightforward. Pop that in, screw the barrel thread protector. Might put a silencer on there. This is a Lalax. Or 9-ball return spring. It's got a thrust race in there, which is quite nice. So that's the completed slide. If you're watching this and wondering where the ejector piece is, I'm actually filming this several months after doing the rest of the video that you've just watched, and I was dismantling it and I lost it, which is a bit dumb, so I'll have to try and find a new Garda one. Other various things have happened since I've started filming this as well. Actually, Knuckles has done a UAC build, but I started this one in July, so I don't know who was first, but hopefully both of them will be fairly in-depth and give you some idea of what products you might want to buy. So finish the slide. There's the rest of the lower, so we can slide those together. That's gone on well. We haven't got a magazine in it at the moment, but this cycles and returns without any stiffness. Obviously, we've done all the usual modifications to the slide, making it flat and things like that. What I'm actually going to do after this video is do a complete tuning guide for the UAC parts. I did have to do some bits to get it to work perfectly. It actually worked and worked fairly reliably straight out of the box, but I did need to modify a few bits and bobs. So there's our completed gun. Let's get a magazine and check everything works. Okay, everything's now completely built. I've got a magazine full of gas, so I'm gonna put that in. Obviously it catches, I've got no bullets in there. That blows back and catches on the slide, so that's working. I can hold that down. So there you go. So as I mentioned, I'm filming this last segment quite a few months after filming the rest of it. I do apologise, I was moving house and all that stuff, so I didn't get round to doing this last bit of filming and uploading to YouTube. So I filmed the rest in July 2016, and I'm filming this video today in January 2017. So obviously I have used the gun. I've also been able to do a bit of fettling with some of the parts that perhaps weren't as slick as they needed to be. But I assure you, everything did work out of the box. I knew previously, as mentioned, that the standard TM piston is not quite big enough to go in the UAC aluminium nozzle, but obviously you could use the standard TM or the Garda nozzle instead, and it would then work fine. So I hope this has been interesting. I've reviewed each item as best I can. You know, there's not really much more to say other than, are they built well and does it work? Well, the answer is yes, it does work. And I think the gun looks quite nice. I've actually tried it with a high capper 5-inch barrel in here, and then I've used the new Garda compact pistol silencer over the top, and it works really well. Obviously it quietens it down a tiny bit, but obviously most of the noise from a GBB is coming out of the back ear when the gas expels. I look forward to having you all along to my YouTube channel again, and I will post a tuning guide for the UAC parts which I've fitted in this gun. Thanks everyone, and see you again soon.